you to be here today at the best primary school in the Federation.
Now it is an honor for the Dr. William Connor Primary School to be a part of the 60-year celebration of the Antioch Baptist Church. We, the Dr. William Connor family, are quite appreciative of the support the church has given to us over the past years. It was renamed from the St. Johnson Village School to the Dr. William Connor Primary School.
Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding.
I never knew that the Lord had plans for me until I heard that the Lord had plans for everyone. Now I know that the Lord has a good plan for making me a great footballer.
He is right, because people were telling him he can't play football, and now he could. And he was trying to learn him to be a goalkeeper like me, and I always tell him to be confident and trust in the Lord with all his heart. And don't study nobody, listen to yourself.
Over the years, the Dr. William Connor Primary School has enjoyed a tremendous, fruitful relationship with the Antioch Baptist Church. And today, on the occasion of the church's 60th anniversary, we are pleased to partner with the Dr. William Connor Primary School in unveiling a plaque which allows visitors, students, and others to get a glimpse of what Dr. Connor looked like and also to celebrate his life. We will also be making a presentation to the reading room of a 75-inch smart television and an accompanying stand. And in collaboration with Amway Enterprises, Mr. Ernest Amway has agreed on the 74th anniversary of the enterprise to provide treats to all the students and the teachers here today.
Now, today is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So let's put our hands together for the Antioch Baptist Church, and I want the members of the 60th anniversary committee to come on stage. Build to last. And if we are truly to last as a federation and to succeed, we have to build.
On behalf of the Antioch Baptist Church, the senior pastor, Pastor Lincoln Corner, the officers and members, we would like to present to the Dr. William Corner Primary School a 75-inch smart television.
We are here at the Kickstart Brilliance Preschool in Limekiln Commercial Development, where the supervisor owner is Miss Toshiba Clark. So today we wish to present to her geometric dome climber, which will help the children with their interactive skills and be able to enjoy greater playtime in this spacious playground.
My name is Toshiba Clark, and on behalf of Kickstart Brilliance Preschool and the children, we want to thank you guys for thinking about us and bringing this toy. The children, they are enjoying it already. They love it. I just tell them to be careful. So once again, thank you very much, and it will be put to great use.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Are you ready to worship tonight? My name is Mario Philip. I want to invite you to just jump on your feet with me as we get ready to enter in. We want to just bow our heads as we prepare our hearts to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, to lift up the I Am That I Am, to offer and render unto Him our simple sacrifice. Because He has done great things, the psalmist says, whereof we Can somebody lift up the name above every other name? And just in case anybody forgot, can you just echo his name tonight? His name is? His name is? The Master's name is? Glory to God in the highest. Heavenly Father, we adore you and we give you special thanks tonight. Father, we thank you, God, that you have drawn us out from our various spaces and places. Father, you have brought us, oh God, from weariness, from tiresome weeks. Father God, from frustrating bosses and co-workers. Father, you have brought us a mighty long way, even 60 years. Father God, it's been a mighty long way, God, you've brought us. And God, we come back, oh God, to say thank you. We come back to raise our Ebenezer. We come back tonight, Father, to lift our voices and join with angels and cry, holy is the Lord. Lord God, Almighty God, we humble ourselves this evening. Father, we say it's not about us. Oh no, it's not about what would have happened before. But God, we bow our lives before you and say, God, we live to worship you. We look to worship you. We raise our heads to you, towards heaven. David says in the Psalms, where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord. And so, God, we raise our hands to the Lord. We raise our voices to the Lord. We raise our heads to the Lord tonight, oh God, in great worship and adoration. God, we say, teach us to worship. Father, cause us not to worship as we worshiped before. Give us, oh God, and now worship. Father God, cause us not to worship as we have, Father, 10 years ago, 30 years ago, 60 years ago. God, give us a worship for now. Father, teach us, oh God, new level worship. Father, that we would enter into your holy of holies, oh God. Tonight, cause our worship to break chains. Father, tonight, cause our worship to draw you closer. Father, we pray, oh God, allow us to enter into your presence tonight. That we would never be the same. God, break yokes this evening. Father, loose bandages. Father, break chains, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. The one that we lift up. But as we lift you up, oh God, lift us up. As we lift you up, lift us up. As we hallow your name, for you are worthy. We say it is so. Amen. It is so, and it will not be otherwise. In Jesus' name. The saints of God agree with me. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Give the Lord a clap this evening. If you're happy to be in his courts, if you're excited about being here, just worship him and join your voice with your clap. With your clapping, now open your mouth and give to him the offering of your lips. Hallelujah. I just want to welcome you into God's house. My name is Mario Philip, and it's a pleasure to be here with you as we partake at the King's Supper. He has called us, and I'm glad that you have come. I had to be here, couldn't miss it, because when God's people, it's so good to get together with God's wonderful people, and you lift up a praise, and I lift up a praise, and sister lift up a praise. It's going to be a blessed night this evening as we celebrate 60 years, and we worship God for 60 more to come. Hallelujah, hallelujah, as we worship God for what he has done before, we know he's going to take us even higher. Amen. I just want to leave this word with you as we anticipate what's going to happen. You know, when there are momentous occasions, normally people look to this passage of scripture in 1 Samuel chapter 7, verse 12. It says, Samuel, he built an altar. He called it Ebenezer, saying, hitherto hath the Lord helped us. And it's good to be helped by God, isn't it? Yes, and we can say that Antioch Baptist Church has been helped by God for 60 years. But I want you to contemplate as we begin to worship that Samuel uttered those words, because at the beginning of that chapter, chapter 7 of 1 Samuel, it starts with the Ark of God. It was lost, and the people were heartbroken because the Ark, the presence of God, was not with them. Could you imagine?
they didn't have the presence of God. They had no presence to enter into. But Samuel said, listen, we are going to pray. If you're serious, let's pray. If you're serious, let's build an altar. If you're serious, let's worship God. Let's let his presence come back to us because we are serious. So I'm saying to you, if you're serious, let's pray tonight. If you're serious, let's worship. If you're serious, let's get our hearts right. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that the enemies came because he realized God's people were serious. But when the enemy came, guess what? The Lord confused the enemy. The Bible says the people of God went out from Mizpah, which is the place that they gathered to worship. And so we can't be like some people. You know, you want God, fight my battles, God, but you're not going out from a place of worship. Oh no. Tonight, everybody here, you would enter in a place of worship. You would fight from a place of worship. Hallelujah. You would lead your family from a place of worship because tonight we go up. Hallelujah. And then you would be able to say, hitherto had the Lord helped us, helped you to enter in to a place of worship. God bless you. Tonight, our first minister to lead us is none other than Jermaine James. And so we are going to worship God with him. Welcome him to God's presence.
Okay, good night, everyone. Oh, it's a wonderful time to be in the presence of the Lord tonight, right? And we came here to worship God. You know, the psalmist said, one thing have I required of the Lord, and that one thing will I be sure of, that I will dwell within his house and inquire in his temple and behold the beauty of a beautiful Savior. I was glad when they said unto me, let's come into the house of the Lord. So we've come to worship tonight, right? And as we worship, you can worship silently, you can worship on your feet, you can worship standing up, you can worship sitting down. You're free to worship as you feel led. You see? More, and I give you more. More, you see? Oh, the worshiper in me wants to be free from the cares of life that seem to weigh me down. And oh, the worshiper in me needs consistency to lift my hands and give you praise when no one's around. And oh, the worshiper in me wants to break free from this intellectual mentality. Like when I should be up, I'm seated in my seat. You should be lifting my hands, giving you praise and glory. I wanna give my best to you. I wanna do what you ask me to. I wanna go wherever you say. Say the word, Lord, I'll obey. I wanna live a life that's real. I wanna serve you, Lord, for real. For you deserve all this and more. And I give you more. More. I give you more. To lift my hands and give you praise when no one's around. Oh, and the worshiper in me wants to break free from this intellectual mentality. Like when I should be up, Lord, I'm seated in my seat. Should be lifting
you ask me to. I want to go wherever you say.
Say the word and I'll obey.
I want to live a life that's real. I want to serve you, Lord, for real. For you deserve all this and more. And I give you more.
Continue to give God that shout, that clap of praise.
You called me out on the water, the great unknown, where feet may fail. There I find you in the mist. My faith, and I will call
upon your name.
Lift my eyes above,
keep my eyes above the waves.
When oceans arise,
my soul will rest in your. Yeah.
take a moment to just bask in the presence of the Lord and just give thanks for who he is. You see?
And I will call upon your name.
Keep my eyes above the waves.
When oceans rise,
my soul will rest in your embrace.
Oh Lord, I am yours. Of God. You see, there's this overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, yes. Leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it. I don't deserve it. Still, he gave himself away, and it's that reckless love that I rely on. Because he loved me, I know that I have a chance. Because he loves me, there's grace. Because he loves me, there's mercy. And well, you guys are singing louder than me tonight, that I've realized, you see. Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. This is personal, you see, God. You've been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You've been so, so. Oh, we're gonna do that verse again, you see? I want you to make it personal right now. Each of us have a testimony. We came here with our testimony. That's why we can praise. And this overwhelming, reckless love of God, we're gonna try to show God how much we love him tonight through our praise. So we're gonna just sing that verse again. Just join me as we say, before I spoke a word, you were singing. God, you've been so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life. And God, you've been so, so kind. Tell you about this love of God, you see. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Oh,
Me down.
for you. You just have to give God a clap, a shout, a roar of praise, you see? Too much, oh, excess love, oh. Jesus, you love me too much, way too much, excess. Let's hear about this love. Your love is kind. Your love is patient. You fill my with so much. Oh, when you're, you see God, you're you make my life, you make my life feel brand new. See, God, you're amazing. You make my life feel brand new. Jesus, you love me too much, oh, too much, oh, too much, oh, excess love.
Jesus, you love me too.
Because you love me too much, oh.
Too much, oh.
Too much, oh. Excess love, oh.
When I think of all you've done and the battles you've won, Jesus, you love me way too much, oh, too much, oh, too much, oh. Lord, when I look back over my life and I think things over, you love me too much, oh, you love me too much, oh, too much, Lord.
Just amazing. Oh, you serve an amazing God, and an amazing God deserves an amazing praise, right? Because 1,000 tongues cannot tell. If I had 10,000 tongues, that still wouldn't be enough. It still wouldn't be enough. Still wouldn't be enough to say, God, I love you. You see, God, you see, you've done so much for me. And I cannot tell it all. And if I had 10,000 tongues, 10,000 tongues, Lord, it still wouldn't be enough. See, when you heal, you heal completely. Oh, chuku maho bimo. We say, oh, we're gonna do that again. We're not gonna build yet. God, for you have done, I could see he's done so much for you. So I'm just gonna let you sing.
What shall I render
to Jehovah?
To Jehovah.
For he has done
so very much for me. What shall I render?
take a moment and think. Think about one thing that God has done for you. Just think about one thing, not the thousands. You won't even begin to think about what 60 years of God's works looks like. But we are here today because of what was started 60 years ago. That has been a lifetime for some people. Some people were born and they're not here to see 60 years today. But some of you were here when this started and you're still here. That's enough to give God thanks. That's enough to give him a shout of praise. Because 60 years ago, something started. And we are here to praise God for what he has done. So after 60 years, you have to ask, what shall I render
to Jehovah?
For he has done a lot.
For he has done so very much for me.
What shall I render to
what
a God?
What shall I render
to God? What shall I give him?
Jehovah.
For he has done.
For he has done so very much for me.
Sing Nara, Nara,
Nara.
One that we're gonna join together and belt out is one that has become popular, very, very popular. No matter how many times you sing it, it's like you're singing it for the first time. You sing it at funerals. I think I've even heard it at a wedding. But when you hear the name, you understand why. The goodness of God never runs out. It never runs dry. So as many times as you could say it, God could be good many, many more times. So as many times as you could think it, God could do it. So we're gonna say, I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me, and all my days I've been. And from the moment that I wake up, Lord, until I lay my head, and I'm gonna sing. And we're gonna reflect on that again. I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me.
All my days,
I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
I am saved in your goodness, God, and all my life.
sing of the goodness of God.
Oh Lord, let me sing.
I love your voice. You have led me to the fire.
And in those dark nights,
Lord,
I know you as a father.
I know you as a father.
And Lord, I know you as my friend.
But
I love you as both, so
I have lived in the goodness of God.
We have to sing that one more time. You see, I love
your voice.
When you talk to God, you see,
you have led me to the fire. In darkest night,
Lord, you are close.
You are close like no other.
I love you as my father.
I know you as my father.
And I know
you as my friend.
Oh,
I have lived in the goodness of God.
And all my life, Lord,
and all my life, you have been faithful.
Lord, you have been so good.
All my life, you have been so good.
With every breath,
that I am able.
I'm gonna sing
of the goodness of God.
I'm gonna sing
of the goodness of God.
I will sing
of the goodness of God.
I'm gonna sing, I can't contain it, so I'm gonna sing
of the goodness.
I'm gonna dance
of God.
I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna sing.
I'm gonna
give you glory. I'm gonna give you praise. I'm gonna lift my hands. I'm gonna give you all you deserve. I'm gonna sing
of the goodness.
I'm gonna sing, Lord. I can't help but sing. 10,000 tongues cannot tell, but I'm gonna sing of the goodness, of the goodness of God.
Of the goodness of God.
When you start to praise, you realize you just can't get enough, right? But we're gonna change the tempo just a bit, and we're gonna say, you see, when sometimes you go through life and you reach what we call rock bottom, and you can't go, you feel you can't go any further. You reach the dead end. What they call it, the cul-de-sac. From there, there's nowhere else to go.
But then there's God. And you see, when you've come to the end of the man-made road and path, you just throw your hands in the air and you say, Father, carry me. When the road is long and heavy, when it's dark and I can't see clearly, I will lift eyes up to the hills, from whence my help it cometh. My help it comes from you. Lead me, oh, lead me, oh, lead me to where I've never been before, a place I've never seen before. Lead me, lead me, lead me, oh, lead me, oh, lead me to where I've never been before, a place I've never seen before. When I've
come to the end of myself,
oh, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. When I've come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. And I can't see clearly, I will lift my eyes up to the hills, from whence my help it cometh. My help it comes from you. So lead me, oh, lead me, oh,
lead me
to where I've never been before, never seen before. But when I've come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. When I've come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. When I've I've never seen before. Lead me, oh, lead me, oh, lead me to where I've never been before, a place I've never seen before. But when I've come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. One who made heaven and earth, you're mighty, stronger than any other. And one thing I have desired of you, that I will dwell with you forever. You're like no other. When I've
come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me.
Father, carry me. Father, carry me.
just a child like me, or a king upon a throne.
He's my forever friend.
so much for worshiping with me tonight.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is anybody a friend of God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have a friend that sticketh even closer than a brother? What joins me and Jesus is more than blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In fact, he shed his own blood just for me. He's our forever friend. Give him another shout of praise in the house. Hallelujah. Exalt the friend who is Jesus. Hallelujah. For he's deserving of our praise. At this time, I don't want you to get comfortable. I don't want you to sit down and get cold, because we're going to move right on in worship. Hallelujah. That's it, sister. We are going to invite our second minister, who is Miss Paige Gumbs, and she is going to take us even further into the presence of God. Are you ready to worship some more? Are you ready to give God your best? Are you ready to exalt the King? Welcome, Minister Paige Gumbs.
Is he good every night? Please forgive me, I need to take off my shoes. I need to worship tonight. So we're gonna worship tonight in spirit and in truth. I'm the salt of the earth. I'm the salt of the earth. I carry the flavor of God. I season the earth. I'm the salt.
I'm highly blessed.
I'm highly blessed.
I'm highly blessed.
I'm highly blessed.
He's so good. He never left. He never let us down. And he never leave us. Want to give thanks to the man of God, Pastor Lincoln Connor. Come on, give praise to the man of God tonight. Give praise to the man of God tonight. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. So we say hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Oh, he's a great God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lamb. Hallelujah. Praise. See?
Measure code, amount to your desire.
what heaven sounds like. Sing unto your Father.
You deserve the praise.
He deserves it.
Worthy is your name.
Sing worthy.
Worthy is your name.
We join with the elders.
Jesus.
We join with the angels.
You deserve the praise.
Lord, we magnify your
worthy
name.
Set up, oh, Zen. Yeah.
fruit of your lips. Give him the fruit of your lips. Give him the fruit of your lips. Oh, we serve such a great God. We serve such a great God. Oh gosh, I feel his presence. I feel so good. I feel so good tonight. I feel so good tonight. We call him Yahweh. We call him Jehovah Jireh. Jehovah Nissi. Jehovah Meshkano. Oh my God, he's El Elyon. Elohim. He's our God. He's our keeper. So we're going to rejoice tonight. We're going to go on bad. Please, if you have your shoes on, please take them off. Because we're going to have a great time tonight in the Lord. Amen. Amen. Oh, what singing. Oh, what shouting. On that happy morning. Savior in the sky, redemption coming. Praise the Lord. Oh, what a wonderful freedom. Lift up the name of Jesus, for the name of Jesus. Say, I'll praise the name.
I'll praise the name of Jesus. Lift up the name of Jesus, for the name of Jesus.
Almighty long way, Lord. Almighty long way. Almighty long way, Lord.
Hallelujah. You want to go further? Do you want to go further? Is this your stop? You want to go on a little bit more? Guess what? He's going to take you further if you want to go further. We are pressing in tonight. We're just getting warmed up. Hallelujah. We sang some deep things. We said, should eternity end and start over again? Even then, so you can't tired now, you can't fret up our worship, no. And we say, yes, Lord, yes, from the bottom of our hearts, oh, glory to God. And why is the reason we sing? Because he's Yahweh. Hallelujah. Are you enjoying yourself in the presence of God? Hallelujah. Are you enjoying yourself in the presence of Daddy Jehovah? Tell your neighbor, you're so nice. Tell your neighbor, you're so nice. Tell your other neighbor, I'm not leaving this here. I'm taking the presence with me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, I have a few announcements for you. Before we go on further, I just want to let everybody know, those who are watching, that they can give to this service, give to this ministry. You know, they can do so by website, that is www.antiochbaptistskn.org. www.antiochbaptistskn.org. And you can either buy a ticket so that you are a part of what is going on here, all right? Not just being blessed, but also being a blessing. Or you can choose to donate any amount, because we are having a grand time in God's presence. Hallelujah. You can also, if you're watching online, you can make your donation via the app, which is ABCSKN. You search for that in the App Store or your Google Play Store, ABCSKN, wherever you find your apps, and you make your donation there. We have not only this wonderful experience in God's presence tonight, but as we celebrate 60 and how Jehovah has brought us a mighty long way. Glory. Did he really do it? Did he really do it? Did he really do it? Amen. So we are continuing to give him praise, but we want to invite you to return to this place, this blessed house, on Sunday afternoon as we continue worshiping and we continue giving God thanks for bringing us a mighty long way. Now, I want you to pay attention to the screen as you'll see a bit more about Sunday.
On Sunday, 5th March 2023, celebrate 60 years with your church, the Antioch Baptist Church. A church that stirs and challenges your soul. A church that cares about your life as a whole. It's on Sunday, 5th March at 4 p.m., Limekiln Commercial Development. Celebrate 60 years with the Antioch Baptist Church. A church for all people, a church for all seasons, a church built to last.
Hallelujah. We are part of a church built to last. Built to last. We are worshiping here with the one. I'm happy to be here with you. And I'm a part of Antioch. Wherever you are, you're visiting, you're part of the ministry. You're part of what God is doing here. Pouring in here. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And built to last. We have to build to last. We are excited about that, so make sure that you join us on Sunday. Now, remember, eternity has not ended yet. No? No. It never going to end either. So we have to continue praising Jesus. We have to continue giving God praise. We have to continue worshiping. And so I want you to get ready for the next level as we're only going higher. We're only going further. We're only digging deeper in God tonight. Get ready for the next level as we welcome our visiting minister, Minister Bridget to Blucher. Glory to God.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Oh, wow. Somebody lift your hands and give him praise. Give him praise. We worship you, we worship you, we worship you. Holy presence fill this place. Your light of love that makes me see how you can love someone like me. Yeah.
rock, my shield, my hiding place. Your holy presence fill this place. Until the break of dawn, I'm gonna stay. Until all darkness fades away. In your presence, say yeah, yeah, yeah. In your presence, Father, that's where I long to be. Say, Lord, I long to be. Saints tonight, let me hear you say, in your
presence,
in your
presence,
Lord, I long to be only Esther, the people's life depends on you, and you gotta bring us out in spite of all what Haman is planning. Hallelujah. You gotta seek God's face. Esther decided in her mind, I've sought the Lord for 3 days and I need to see the king. Somebody said, but the king has not called you, Esther. Esther said, if I perish, let me perish, but I got to be in the presence of the king. Hallelujah. I don't know what you're going through tonight, but tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, excuse me, I came to get in his presence. Lord, I belong to me. Only in your. There are things that he alone can do. Say, Lord, I belong to me. Only in your on, Saint Kids, this room is filled. Mr. Engineer, just give me a couple more in my mind. This room is filled with praises already tonight. I greet you in the name that is above every other name. I need you to look at your neighbor. Thank you, Mr. Engineer. That's good. Keep it up there. Say, look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I don't know what you came to do, but I got a praise. And I came to get it out. Now somebody shout hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, hark the voice of Jesus, holy. Who will go and work today? The fields are wide and the harvest is waiting. Has brought us a mighty long way, and indeed we are happy to be alive. Hallelujah. To many dangers, toil and snares, somebody said many years I searched for rest, couldn't find perfect rest. But somebody said all you've got to do is lose yourself Tell your neighbor, say, lose yourself. Say, you're too full of yourself. Lose yourself. Say, kids, are you in the house? Let me hear you say, lose yourself. Many years I've searched for rest, perfect peace within my breast, and I often sought the Lord alone in tears. But one day while knelt in prayer, Jesus whispered to me there, take the cross and follow me to Calvary. Help me sing the song tonight. What do you say? Let me lose. I will me. Yes, my problems fade away, cause my master knows my care, and he's with me everywhere. Lift up your voice and I'll sing it now.
Bigger than all my problems, bigger than all my faith. God is bigger than any mountain that I can or cannot see.
Thank you.
to make sure everyone in the house was saved. He just told him to mark the house. Somebody said legacy, legacy. Are you standing up like you don't know what I'm talking about? When the death angel passed, it doesn't matter who is inside. Some of you have some children. They are not saved yet. And you're fussing with them. Don't you dare fuss with them. Put the blood. Put the blood. Put the blood. Put the blood. Put the Jesus help me tonight. Mama, stop worrying. Papa, stop worrying. Your daughter is coming home. Your son is coming home. That divided home will be mended again. If it's the will of the Lord. When the dead angel passed, I and the rabble shake. Somebody lift your hands and give him prayer. Now lift your voice and help me say, say when
I see the blood.
Hey, yeah, yeah. Disclaimers. I remember praying to the Lord, St. Kitts, and I asked the Lord not to allow me to entertain people. But I also asked him to help me sing with understanding. As I sit or stand here in St. Kitts and sing, I sing in the very atmosphere. And I take dominion and authority over the words of God in the songs. Because it's through the words. Can I tell you something? When we sing here, and the melody and the lyrics goes up and please the Lord, then there is a communication. That's when we see healing taking place. When there is an agreement, we first have to agree in the earth, even in our singing. So I know that in this season, a lot of people are going to be disappointed with some of the singers. Because God did not take us through 2 years of COVID to come out to entertain you. So if you still want to go to concert in the same attitude like you used to before we were shut down, then that's all on you. But I'm going to take Joshua's word tonight. Joshua said, as for me, thank you.
and you're required
to bless the song.
Somebody tell me tonight, how can we
sing the Lord's song
in a strange
excuse me, but I need to ask you, do you realize what you're singing? No, seriously. What comes out of your mouth does not always agree with the heart. So I don't care how happy you feel tonight. Make sure your dance comes. Make sure your dance carries weight. Let your dancing do all what you wanted to do in prayer. When you lift your feet up, go down and stamp on the plans and the assignment from the pit of hell tonight. We are the warriors. Just don't dance and sweat and leave the concert and say it was a good concert. But I pray that there is an agenda. When you dance tonight, let your dance count. Because 2,000 years ago, our Father went on a hill called Calvary. Mm-hmm. days of spent in vanity and pride. Hey! Caring not, my Lord was crucified. Knowing not it was for me he died. What do you say?
The Calvary.
Say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was mercy blind to me.
Hey, yeah, yeah.
There my burden soul from liberty.
Hey.
At Calvary.
Say. Now I give to Jesus everything.
Everything.
Now I gladly own him as my king.
As my king. Are you washed in the blood
tell you something. Say, I am blessed and I'm highly favored. And there's nothing you can do about it. I don't think they hear you. The neighbor, you can sit there looking all stush. But if you know what he has done for me, where he has brought me from, say, neighbor, move over, move over. Say, move over. I came to praise him. Somebody say, I can't sit down. I came to praise him. Somebody lift your hands and say, I can't sit down because he saved me. Hold it, hold it. I need all the stoosh people to put up your finger and leave right now. I don't care how much you pay for your ticket. If you're sitting up here waiting for a cheerleader, I want you to look back 2 years ago when you was on lockdown. Well, want to come outside and couldn't. Now you come into the house of the Lord, cutting your tail. Don't want to sweat. Don't want to mess up your little weave. Don't worry about me. I'm the smart one. I don't glue weave. I sew weave. Because when the Holy Ghost, somebody say, when I think of the goodness, somebody shout hallelujah. I need somebody up in the air to scream. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, say, neighbor, say, do what you want, but I can't. Problem is, I'm asking the musician to play. I can't sit down when they're sitting down. That's a serious problem. So I have to ask Holy Ghost to allow them to please sit. Listen, y'all don't mess with me up in here. Sister Toby, all you got to do is speak it. We are in an atmosphere. And all this excitement you're getting on with is not necessary. All you got to do is believe. What you speak, believe. What you pray, believe. What you say, believe. And expect the Holy Ghost to activate. So we're going to ask the Holy Ghost to let the musician sit and play. Me can't sit down. But if there's somebody in your row that is singing, me can't sit down. And they sit down. Look exactly where their foot is. I'm not promoting violence. I'm sorry. I was going to tell you to get in the spirit and kind of step on your feet, but I'm not promoting. You fully well know where you was coming to. You was coming to a gospel concert. Oh, some of you are dealing with Arthur and his righteous family. We're going to pray for that tonight. We're going to drive out Arthur and all his cousins, all the righteous. They're going to leave us tonight. Because we came with a praise. We came with a praise. We came with a praise. What do you say? Can't sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down.
Can't sit down.
No, me can't sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down.
Can't sit down.
For all he has done for me, how he set my spirit free. He even drank a bitter cup for me. No, me can't sit down. From by the door to Calvary, he took a walk for you and me. Then they nailed him to a tree. No, me can't sit down.
No harm, no harm, no harm, no harm, no harm.
praising. Somebody praising.
Somebody praising.
Hey.
Somebody praising.
6 years. You got to praise it. Somebody praising. Somebody praising. Put up your eyes. Get something and wave it. Put up your flags. Get something and wave it. Put up your eyes. Get something and wave it. worthy to be praised. We're going to land this plane. But we need to roll back the curtains. Need to roll back the curtains. Let me see the hands of the survivors. He's worthy. He's been in the storm, and it seemed like forever. And your nights of confusion, it seems oh so long. Your ship has lost anchor, and your storm got you drifting. But your night's almost over, so ride out your storm. Need an encouraging word. You're not alone. You're hurting, you're hurting, you're hurting, you're hurting. Hurting. What's your answer? Your answer. Somebody, we're getting ready to go out of here. I need to really minister to somebody tonight. Your problem is not who you're looking at. Your problem is that you don't know how to let go. Your problem is that you think that your prayers are not being answered. That's because you want them answer when you want them answer. But I came to remind you that God's ways and our ways are two different things. His timing and our timing is two different things. Your prayers have been answered, but you need to make the adjustment and leave them. Don't pray and pick them up again. God is not hard of hearing. Remember his promise. He said, I'll never, never leave you. Though the waters are raging, they will do you no harm. So don't give up. Don't give up this battle. You came too far. For your answer is coming. Hey, just hold on to Jesus. And ride off your song. Ride out your song. God's riding. He's coming. He's coming. He's coming. You may. You're not alone. touch your neighbor and say, right out here. Be a Barnabas, be a Barnabas. Encourage somebody. God's rising. Come on, come on. Wonder the great Nesta Marley penned a song many years ago. He said he rise up in the morning. He went outside. He said there were three little birds outside his doorstep. Now this is coming from a Rastafarian. I oftentimes ask myself, why he didn't see one? Why not two? God. I believe the Spirit of God was so much in that man. Sister Toby, he said, three little birds outside my doorstep. Sing. singing sweet songs of melody, pure and true, saying, this is my message. And what was he saying? Don't worry. You know, some of us too religious, you know. Some of you hear me quoting Bob Marley, think, well, listen to the lyrics, forget who sing it. It's a message. And I'm pondering, I'm going to do my last song. I'm pondering, 60 years, do you think that Pastor Connor could not have the concert tomorrow night, the 4th? Hey, Jesus, have mercy. We are in the 3rd month. It's the 3rd day of 2023. The concert said refreshing worship. Come on, people. Hey, and the rabble shot. There is about to be a new record. Assembly. I'm gonna sing my last song. Like I told you, I didn't come here to entertain you. You're in a race, and the day that you feel like you're tired and want to give up and drop out of this race, remember there's somebody around the bend with their hand stretched waiting for the baton. You can't give up now. You're in the middle of the race. It's not about you. Every time you step to step out of the race, remember, somebody got to anchor. Somebody got to take the baton from you. Stay in your lane. God said, finish the race. Do me a favor. If you don't believe me, go on your internet or your Facebook or your Instagram. There is a new face of prophets. There's a new face of ministers. Some of us need to be adjusted. God is going to send some tattooed people. Some of the people that you passed and thought you know their history. I know who Pastor Connor is, so I'm safe here. Let me be, I know we're streaming, so let me say that. There are going to be some churches that will never, ever open again. Because we have gone too far in our own ways. I'm talking to the pastors now. I'm talking to the leaders now. We're here celebrating 60 years. I don't believe Pastor Connor felt like coming to church every day. I don't believe that he felt like going on when some of you ridiculed his name, tore his name to pieces. Can I speak? But he stood with his hand. And he took the baton. He had to preach. I tell you, I thank God for COVID. I wrote a book and I wrote about the silent tear. There's some of us when we go through some stuff. Some of us can be in the room with somebody else and they don't even know the pressure that we are under. But for the grace of God. And sometimes, I used to think, Sister Toby, I said, God, I cried some secret tears. He said, no, I gave you the pillow as a witness. Every drop of tears that hit the pillow, I heard it. You are a survivor. I don't care what you've been through. You are valuable. I don't care who left you. I don't care who hurts you. Okay, Lord, I hear you. Yeah. As a matter of fact, let me clear that hurting part up. Because in Luke 10 or 9, around there, he said, I've given you the authority. Right? And I love the last line. God said, stop saying people hurt you. The only thing that get hurt is our flesh. Our spirit can never get hurt. So when people say things and it hurt you, it's just your ego reacting. But your spirit is intact. Can I encourage somebody tonight? I'm from the island of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And I'm from the country. And I tell people all the time, country people are very wise people. Don't sorry for me, you tongue people. Don't sorry for me. Because there are some trees that you throw all the garbage. You know what I'm talking about. And those are the trees that bring forth the biggest fruit. What am I saying? I'm going to sing my last song for you. But I need for you to go home encouraged tonight. When people throw garbage on you, stop complaining. Keep rejoicing. In Matthew 24, you and I were forewarned. He said, the world don't like me and they won't like you. They will come against you for my name's sake. I know you want to go. I'm going to sing the last song. And let me tell you something. If people don't know anything about you, when people start talking about you, all they're doing is giving you free advertisement. I've been battered, bruised and torn, but I'm still here. Some days my life, it was filled with fear, but thank it, I'm still here. So many times I had to fight just to say, Shakir, disappointment. And there were days when I thought I would not make it. Oh, but I'm still here. So many storms I had to bear. Lord, for your joy, they can't compare. Storms of sickness, storms of strife, but I'm still here. I need to sing that again. I had many disappointments, but I'm still here. Who am I talking to? And there were days when I thought I would not make it. Oh, but Mama, I'm still here. So many storms I had to bear. Lord, for your joy, they can't compare. Storms of sickness, storms of strife, but I'm still here. This is my verse, this is my verse. I've been abused and misused. Been persecuted and accused. But tonight, we gotta go, we gotta go, we gotta go, we gotta go. Lord, it's such joy to know that your love, Brenda, has kept. Come on, say it, kids. Through the valley. Perhaps. Now everybody lift your voice with me.
Great things he has done.
Amen.
It's
you make your way to your homes just before you leave, we want to give God praise. For all the glory belong to the Lord. Amen. We want to thank our musicians. Our media team. Our singers, those on the platform and those in the congregation. Our ministers, Jermaine James. Paige, Gumbs. And evangelist Bridget, Blucher. And we want to thank you for coming. And we look forward to you being here with us on Sunday. First at 5:30 at Frigibe Beach, we have a sunrise service and baptism. And then at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we have our anniversary service here. Thank you so very much. I know you have been blessed, challenged, stirred. Be safe. And I pray that we have been reassured in our faith. And if you do not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, there is no better time than now for you to make that decision. I pray that in God's gracious mercy, that if you do not know him, he would allow you the opportunity. But if he comes or calls tonight, which is very possible, he may come. And if he doesn't come, he may call. And when he calls, it means you'll be going out into eternity. And since none of us holds the key, since the word of God reminds us that from our first cry to our last, Christ appoints our destiny. It is scary to live without him. If you think of it, he knows when you are making your final step. That's scary. So I pray that he would give you wisdom, discernment for his name and his mercy's sake. Amen. Can we do the blessing? Ladies, Lord bless you and keep you. You can go out on this one. If you are desirous, you are free to leave. If you want to finish on this one, may we together. Thank you very much, Shabana.